Greetings everyone, it's Borko from Plumsail. In this brief video, I will walk you through the process of creating an interactive org chart for SharePoint and Microsoft Teams utilizing Entra ID, or formerly Azure AD, as our data source. Let's jump right in. If you choose Entra ID as your preferred data source, Plumsail Org Chart will create an org chart based on the information from your Entra ID. So your Entra ID should look something like this. You have all of these fields like display name, first name, last name, job title, department, and you will populate data for these fields according to your company standard. And I assume you will populate this field manager, which is used by Plumsail Org Chart to build the org chart structure. And no further action is necessary in here. Next step is to add Plumsail Org Chart to your SharePoint. If you haven't done that yet, I will leave a video in the description section how to add Plumsail Org Chart to your SharePoint. Once the org chart is added to your SharePoint, you can go to Edit Site, click on this plus sign to add it as a web part. Then once the org chart is added, we will start the configuration process. And the first thing we have to do is to select Entra ID as our data source. Before we use Entra ID as our data source, we have to approve an API access request, which will allow Plumsail Org Chart SPFX package to access users' profiles in Entra ID. But first, I would like to invite you to sign up for a 30-day free trial and test Plumsail Org Chart by yourself. I will leave a link for this offer in the description section. And also, you can subscribe and get notified when we release future videos. Let's get back to setting up Entra ID. There are three steps involved in this process. Step one is to log into your Microsoft 365 Admin Center with your admin account, then go to SharePoint Admin Center. Then step two, in SharePoint Admin Center, expand Advanced section and click on API Access. You will see pending requests from Plumsail Org Chart. And in step three is to select this pending request and approve it. Now you can use your Entra ID as a data source for your org chart. In the configuration process for org chart, we can select to display vacancies, and there is a video on how to do it in the description. In the filtration tab, I will choose an employee from my demo data as a root person, but if your Entra ID is structured correctly to showcase your employees and their managers, you don't have to do it. Org chart will detect the structure automatically based on the current hierarchy. So org chart will basically go through the employees list and look for the first employee without the manager and showcase it as a root person. In design tab, we can choose from different layouts and designs, but for now, I will skip this part. And the next is templates tab. We can choose what to be displayed in the box template and be shown as the org chart loads at the beginning. And then we can choose what's visible in tooltip template and search template as well. Once we publish it, we can go back at any time and reconfigure it. From here, we can add it to Microsoft Teams as a tab and share it with our employees. There is a separate video in the description on how to do this. Thank you for watching. I hope we helped with this video, and see you soon.